property damage to me is not violence. It's not a human life. I don't know how we can talk about damaging windows in the same breath as talking about Tort getting shot, killed, and shot over 13 times. What I am worried about is the loss of trust with the public. What I am worried about is the fact that the public feels so helpless that they're being driven to this. We've heard time and time again, we talk about being the birthplace of the civil rights movement. Well, civil rights leaders all have said that when the public, that riots and protests are the voice, are the voices of the unheard. People feel driven to this point, and we have to take it. We also have to look at ourselves and take responsibility for that. We are very complicit in the property damage that has taken place. The things that we're calling, the things that the city is calling violent, we push for those things to happen by not listening to the public. And so to sit here and point fingers and not take any responsibility or any of the blame is a failure in leadership. We shouldn't even be out there. This is what APD has no legal jurisdiction on this land. We should not be out there sending what's estimated $40,000 a day per officer, like to send off to, for these patrols. We, one, should not even be there. This land has the jurisdiction of the CAB and the state. But that being said, the escalation is troubling. It scares the ever-living crap out of me because I was terrified when the first arrests happened in the forest right before Christmas. And I said to my colleagues, if we do not come together now and get the administration up to the table, someone's going to die. And that is what happened. And my worst fears came true because somebody whose death is completely preventable ended up happening. And my fear is with continued escalation that the number of people that will become, that will be injured and or killed will only grow. And that terrifies me because our responsibility should be first protecting civilians. I don't like whether or not they're from here. It doesn't matter. A human life is a human life. So what's more important, winning the argument or protecting people? Which is why we need to take a beat and come back to the table and have a lot of questions and figure out how we're going to move forward. And why in God's name are we carrying the water for APF? Makes no sense to me. And the fact that there, as I, as an elected official, cannot get certain questions answered and have tried now for months, which is why you haven't heard me say anything, because I was trying really hard to get more buy-in, to get more answers, and that has not happened. So, I still have questions about the lease, land that will actually be used, how it'll be used, the general setup. If I hear one more damn time it's not really a forest, I'm gonna rip my hair out. The questions I have is around the kind of the niche pieces around softwood versus hardwood, how the trees are going to be planted, how wildlife is going to be protected, how are they going to not further pollute one of the most endangered water basins in the country? How are they going to mitigate the cost of water for the surrounding black and brown populations? The CSAC board makes no sense to me. There are people on there that are calling for there to be a halt, and that's not happening. That's the reason that they're supposed to be there. Some, in my opinion, have a conflict of interest because they're related to officers. APF has a vote on that committee. They absolutely should not have a vote on their own project. These are the questions I've sought answers to, understanding what type of explosive would be used, how they're going to atone for the fact that we're building or proposing building a facility on a graveyard of people that died at the prison farms because of brutal conditions by police. How are we going to protect the Chattahoochee Brick Factory and not the place where the bodies were sourced from? Just all of it. What is it like? Are there going to be any restrictions on the 43% of people coming here? Are we going to make sure that none of them have a training facility, like a training program similar to Gilead, Georgia State? Are we going to make sure we're not working with people who do IQ capping? Are we going to make sure that we're not working with agencies that are still practicing the same techniques that got George Floyd killed? There are so many questions that have not been answered. And also 90 million, where did this arbitrary number come from? And also, isn't it more than that now? How much of this are we covering? And there's just so many things that have not been answered. And closing our eyes and hoping it goes away is not a tactic. So, Chief is in here. Maybe I can go ask him some questions. Do y'all mind?